Michigan Republican Senate candidate John James is coming under fire for expressing an idea that leadership can be a masculine responsibility. Watch this.
Men, we have a charge to lead. And we are failing in that because we are afraid to hurt someone's feelings. The fact of the matter is women want men who've been tested. And boys need to be tested.
And so women like strong men. Well, don't just ask that guy. Ask anybody who's ever studied the subject. There are reams of social science on this question, and most Americans think it sounds sensible. But just for uttering these words, one writer at the Detroit Metro Times has accused James of seeking a Handmaid's Tale-style theocracy. John James joins us tonight. Ms. James, thank you very much for coming on. So before we get to what your critics are saying about you, why don't you tell us what you were saying when you uttered those words?
Absolutely. I was raised in the church, and I know, based upon my priorities, which is God and country in that order, I also recognize we talk a lot about rights in this country, but not enough about responsibilities. I believe that we all have to step up. We are all created equal, male and female, but I truly believe, because of how I was raised, that men have an obligation to step up and not abandon their family responsibilities, to step up and be role models and mentors in their community. And when I was talking to a faith-based business organization, talking to men, talking about stepping up in their communities and holding themselves accountable to be mentors, the reason is, right now, the left has very little way to attack me other than take things out of context or just flat out lie. I'm not going to fit in anybody's blue box or anybody's red box. I'm a conservative who believes very, very strongly in faith and family, God and country, and service before self. That's why I went off to serve my country in Iraq. That's why I came back to build up my community right here in Detroit. And that's why I'm going to go to Washington and continue to serve my state.
So just to be clear, you think that men should take care of the families they create. And for that, you're some kind of Ayatollah.
Imagine that. I think that right now, particularly in the African-American community, I believe that if I can be frank, and I know I can be on this show, that the overwhelming number of African-American females having children are doing so and managing their role and responsibility as a single parent. I believe that men need to step up. And that's what I was talking about. And the left attacking me for that just proves that their business model is dependent upon keeping black folks dependent and in debt and keeping them in the situation so they can make sure that they depend on the left for their vote. I'm not talking about left or right. I'm not talking about black or white. I'm talking about the right thing, a message of economic opportunity where we focus on early childhood development, K through 12 education. But you have people here who talk a good game and talk about fixing the school system here, talk about getting people out of their blight and their socioeconomic downtrodden state. But then you have the ACLU who continues to allow these things to get in the way. And I'm about creating freedom and opportunity for everyone, particularly in my community here in Detroit.
Good for you. Families are a threat to them. Married people vote Republican. They hate the family as a result. That's the truth, and I hope you'll keep telling it. Thank you very much for coming on tonight.